that we didn't mention, that we're really doing a lot of.
Well, I think in the beginning, you have to have the drive and the motivation to get up every day and make it work, because if it's not you yourself doing it, nobody else is going to do it for you, number one. And you've got to find the right people, the personnel. In a business like we have, we rely on our employees to do the work for us at this point. You know, starting out, it was, we knew we would make the customer happy because it was me and him that was doing it.
Yep.
And we had certainly a vested interest in making sure that that happened on every job. But, you know, getting to a point where you're growing, you've got to hire people to do those jobs. Mm-hmm. So you've got to make sure that they're trained, they're professional, you know, you can trust them, they're good with your customers, and that they, you know, adhere to the same, you know, vision that you have day to day. And it's just taking care of the customer. I mean, if you focus on taking care of the customer, you'll always make the right decisions.
I found that family support was a big thing for starting up. Neither of us would be able to do it here without the help and support of our family, just from small things to the point that when we're working 60, 70 hours a week, on call 24/7 for 2 years straight before we actually got to a point that we had enough employees off that we could take off and have a day off or anything like that. The fact that my mom came over and helped clean my house when I wasn't there one time. Like, you'd be really surprised how much the little stuff like that goes a long way with it. Mm-hmm. But I would say it takes a supportive family unit, friend circle, and a work ethic that basically you're going to work twice as hard as anybody else for a lot of years, mm-hmm, before you don't have to anymore.